Okay. To find the maximum values, minimum values, local maximum, local minimum, we built some theories in the previous section, and at the end of the section, we were able to find the absolute maximum, absolute minimum over a closed interval. We said if we have a function that is continuous over a closed interval, then for sure there will be an absolute maximum and absolute minimum. And we said this is very interesting and very important idea, and it is always repeated in final exams. The next theorem, or the next section will treat this idea, is 4.2. The title is the mean value theorem. The title is mean value theorem. Actually, we have two theorems here. We have Rolle's theorem and the mean value theorem. And at the end, we study the relationship between the derivative of a function and the number zero. When the derivative is equal to zero, and if the derivative is equal to zero, what kind of function do we have? So three points need to be discussed in this section. It is given the title, the mean value theorem, because this is considered one of the most important theorems in mathematics. And this theorem is the theorem that makes the link between Math 101 and Math 102, which is called the mean value theorem, the integral calculus and the differential calculus. There is a nice theorem there called the fundamental theorem of calculus. And it is proved using this mean value theorem. Okay, before we go to the mean value theorem and state it, we have something called Rolle's theorem. Of course, these are two mathematicians. One of them is called Rolle, so this is the name of the theorem based on this mathematician. What does it say? The theorem says, let f be a function that satisfies the following three hypotheses or three conditions. What are they? What are the three hypotheses we need? The first one, we need the function to be continuous in the closed interval. And we know what's the meaning of this. When I say continuous over the closed interval, when I say continuous over the closed interval AB, this is a closed interval AB, and I need it to be continuous. It means it's supposed to be continuous in between. It's supposed to be continuous from the left at B and continuous from the right of A. خلاص يا شباب ما يحتاج نكتب على اللي هو عبد الملك الوحيد اللي ما واجهت مشكلة في الخيارات. It's okay. خلاص واضحة المشكلة بما أن الأغلب كاتم 5 يعني we have a problem. So let us raise it to the tech committee and inshallah they will treat it. But I need from you to raise a ticket in the web assigned that you have problem. Okay, the second point for the function need to be satisfied is that the function f must be differentiable over the open interval AB. The last condition. F of A must be equal to F of B. The value of A is equal to the value of B. And the theorem says now, the result says, in this case, there is a number C in AB such that F prime of C is equal to zero. Let me just show you like a diagram here. Then we come back to see the examples we have about the theorem. The theorem says if you have a point here called A, a point here called B, and you have the image here at A is exactly equal to the image at B, and you need to connect them. You need to join them. You need to join them with a curve that is continuous. There is no jump. There is no infinite discontinuity. There is no removable discontinuity. All the way, the function is differentiable also between A and B. Then the theorem says at least one time you will turn out smoothly. You need to turn out smoothly, meaning you should have at least one horizontal tangent here. There's supposed to be a point here called C between A and B, such that the derivative of the tangent line at that point must be equal to zero. يعني you do need to come this way because the function will not be differentiable. You cannot come this way and leave a space here and come back because the function is continuous. If everything is fine, continuity, differentiability, then at least one time you need to turn out and come back to the same point. Maybe one time, two times, three times. For example, here there's another turning point. Here is a third one. This is the meaning of the theorem. Okay, let us see the three cases we have for the theorem or different cases we have for the theorem. لاحظوا مثلا part A. Part A, we have a straight line. That is case number one. We have straight line, exactly a straight line. Do we have a point between A and B such that the derivative is equal to zero? The answer is all, yes. All points there the derivative is equal to zero. So if the function is constant, the theorem will be guaranteed. يعني all points between A and B, the derivative must be equal to zero. هذه الحالة الأولى. طبعاً I'm talking about the proof of the theorem, لكن it is not required from you and it is, I will say it in words only. I will not write it down. الحالة الأولى إذا كانت الدالة constant, for sure the derivative is equal to zero in between A and B. طيب الحالة الثانية شلون؟ If we have f of x, let us come here and add the page. If we have f of x, مثلا this is the xy plane and I have, for example, f of a is here. طبعا f of a is equal to f of b, isn't it? F of a is equal to f of b. We have f of a and f of b. They have the same altitude. This is a, this is b. They have the same altitude. الآن الاحتمال الثاني شنو؟ أنه if it is not a constant, if it is not a constant, يعني there is a point x, f of x greater than f of a. لازم تكون في نقطة أعلى من النقطتين، صحيح؟ هذا احتمال. For some point between a and b. طيب الآن الاكستريم فاليو ثيورم، تتذكروا الاكستريم فاليو ثيورم، isn't it؟ الاكستريم فاليو ثيورم شو تقول؟ تقول since the function is continuous over the closed interval, there must be absolute maximum and absolute what? Minimum. طيب إذا كان ال f of x greater than f of a وال f of a equal to f of b، معناها هذا ال absolute maximum will appear at in between a and b, not exactly at a, not exactly at b, isn't it? طيب وإذا كانت تظهر شيء إيش يسموها؟ يسموها local maximum أيضا في نفس الوقت. And by Fermat's theorem, if you remember Fermat's theorem شو تقول؟ يقول if the function is differentiable, if the function is differentiable and it has a local maximum, then the derivative at that point must be what? Must be zero. فتحصلنا على نتيجة الروزي ثيورم. There is a point C for which the derivative is zero. نفس الشيء لو كان ال f of x less than f of a, which is equal to f of b. معناته there is an absolute minimum. This absolute minimum also what? A local minimum. And if it is local minimum and the derivative exists, يعني the function is differentiable, so the derivative will be exactly equal to zero by what we call Fermat's theorem. This is how to prove the theorem, which is not required from you, but I need you to understand the theorem itself. Look for the four shapes here we have. Here we have f of a is equal to f of b. The function is very smooth. There is no corners. There is no jump discontinuity. There's no removable discontinuity. There is no infinite discontinuity. There is no vertical tangent, etc. The theorem says at least one time between a and b, I have a tangent line. And this tangent line has a slope is equal to zero. The derivative is equal to zero. Is it only one time? The theorem says at least one time. But maybe you have one, two tangents where the derivative is equal to zero. So this is the meaning of the theorem. And this is how to prove it. If you have any question about the meaning, please go ahead and ask your question. Okay, I am summarizing here for you in a remark says, what does it mean geometrically, Rolle's theorem? Rolle's theorem says, if the conditions are satisfied, يعني the function is continuous over the closed interval, it is differentiable over the open interval, f of a is equal to f of b, okay? Then there is at least one point in the graph, I call it C, f of c, for example, and this point is on the graph where the tangent line is horizontal, where the tangent line is horizontal. Now, what is the classical question about the theorem? What is the classical question about the theorem? They'll give me a function and a given interval, and they will say, find out the value of C that satisfies the Rolle's theorem. Find the value of C that satisfies the Rolle's theorem. If it is like saying that also verify the conditions, it means also I need to verify the three conditions we have in the theorem. Okay, for the first time, I will do everything and then I will read it, I mean, orally for the conditions. The first one, what is the first condition? I need to mention this. F is the first condition is the continuity. So I will say F is continuous on the closed interval. من يقول لي why this function is continuous over the closed interval?
Polynomial.
أحسنت. Since it is polynomial. We know that polynomials are always continuous. So it is continuous because it is polynomial. The second condition here, f is differentiable over the open interval, on this open interval, 0, 2. Again, because it is polynomial, so polynomials are always differentiables. Now look for the conclusion. Still, we have one condition. We need the value of C here is very important between A and P open. I need to have the third condition here. The third condition says, I need to evaluate F of 0. What is F of 0 here when you substitute 0? That is equal to what? 1. Is it equal to F of 2? Okay, let us substitute 2. We have 8. 2 squared is 4 by 2. That's 8. So 8 minus 8 would be 0 plus 1 is equal to 1. So we have 1, 2, 3 conditions are satisfied. And in the shlon, there is a number, the Rosie theorem says, there is a number C between 0 and 2 such that what? F prime of C must be equal to 0. We need to find this conclusion now. We need to find this conclusion. So this implies there is a number C between 0 and 2 such that F prime of C must be equal to 0. If you allow me to take this one a little bit down so I have enough space to write. Okay. So what is F prime of X? What is the derivative of the example we have here? This one, X cubed minus 2X squared. The derivative will be 3X squared minus 4X. 3X squared minus 4X. So I will write here, this implies in the 3X squared, yeah, 3C squared minus how much we said 4X, is it? Is equal to 0. What is that? Minus 4x, yes, minus 4x, so it is minus 4c is equal to 0. I found the derivative and I substitute c and make it equal to 0. Simplifying, I will take the c as a common factor. Then I have 3c minus 4 is equal to 0. I have two possibilities. I have c equal to 0 or C is equal to 4 over 3. طبعا C is equal to 0 does not belong to 0, 2, isn't it? This one belongs to 0, 2. Which one satisfies the conclusion of Rosie theorem? The answer will be only 4 over 3. So in the exam, if he said how many C's satisfy the conclusion of the Rosie theorem, I will tell him only there is one conclusion, which is 4 over 3. So 0 is not accepted because it is not inside the open interval. لاحظوا النقطة هذه مهمة جدا. Always in the theorem, he said there is a point in between A and B, not between A and B closed, but it is between A and B open. So we should be careful about this. طيب. Let us go to the second example here, sine 2 pi x between minus 1 and 1. The theorem says if this function is continuous, differentiable, okay, and f of a is equal to f of b, there will be at least one point between minus 1 and 1 whose derivative is equal to 0, whose tangent line is horizontal. طيب خلينا نشوف هل السين فانكشن كونتينوس؟ هل الفانكشن هذه كونتينوس؟
الأول
f of x is خلينا نقول f simply the name is f. f is of x is the image at x. f is continuous on the closed interval minus 1 and 1. واحد. Number two, f is differentiable on this interval, and not only this, even we can't find the derivative. It is, these two conditions are true because since it is trigonometric functions. طيب يا دكتور الآن إذا جبتنا سؤال زي كده في الكويز, should I show these conditions? You need to list them, and I will mention now couple of functions that are continuous over their domain. And you can say, since it is polynomial, since it is trigonometric function, for example, since it is a rational function, rational functions are continuous over their domain. So the only thing we need to check that none of the excluded points from the domain are inside the given interval. What else? The inverse trigonometric functions, logarithmic functions, exponential functions, all the famous functions we know, except the integer function, the piecewise defined function. We need to check whether they are continuous over the given interval or not. Number three, what is the image at minus one? What is the
image? Minus one equal to f of
one. This is equal to sine of minus 2π. And minus 2π will give me what? Will give me zero. And this is exactly equal to sine of 2π, which is equal to f of one. Yani f of one is equal to f of minus one. Some books, they required f of a equal to f of b equal to zero. بعض الكتب راح تلاحظوا إذا تقرأوا بعض الكتب الأخرى راح تلاحظ الشرط هذا موجود إن f of a equal to f of b equal to zero. ما محتاجين إحنا يكون equal to zero exactly. But some books they write this condition equal to zero. It is not needed. طيب الآن تحققت الشروط الثلاثة صحيح. What is the conclusion? What is the conclusion? The conclusion there is a number C, maybe one, maybe more than one, between the open interval minus one and one, such that what? F prime of C must be equal to zero. Must be equal to zero. طيب خلونا نجيب the derivative. What is the derivative of the function sine 2π x?
Sine 2π.
2π cosine
times 2
of 2π x. صحيح. I need to substitute by c, so this will be 2π c must be equal to zero. طيب dividing by 2π, I have cosine 2π c is equal to zero. من يعطيني أصفار الكوساين؟ متى الكوساين تساوي زيرو؟
Yeah,
give me a general formula for it. Do you know this? يعني لو واحد سألك سؤال الآن sin x equal to zero راح تقول له هذه بسيطة، هذه ال x equal to n by دائما multiple of by where n is integer. This will give me the zeros of the sign. طيب what about the cosine؟ الآن احنا نحتاج cosine of x equal to zero. من يقول؟ What is
2n pi plus 1.
X equal to?
2n pi plus 1.
Yeah, 2n plus 1 times by, باقي لك شغلة. Over?
Over 2.
Over 2. By over 2, 3 by over 2, 5 by over 2, minus by over 2, minus 5 by over 2, minus 7 by over 2, and etc. Where n is an integer. هذه لازم تحفظوها. N belong to Z. هذه القاعدة اللي هي zeros of sign. And the zeros of cosine. I will use them to solve this exercise. Of course, I need the second one to solve the exercise. If you need to take a note, I will delete it. So please, if you need to take a note, take it now. Sine x equal to zero, x equal to n by, where n is an integer, cosine x equal to zero, then x equal to 2n plus 1 by over 2, where n is also integer. يلا نستخدم هذه الآن. معنى الكلام هذا ان 2π c okay let me write it down 2π c whatever inside the cosine supposed to be equal to 2n plus 1 over 2 multiplied by where n belong to z. جميل. Let us divide by 2π in order to get c value. So the C value is equal to, I will divide by 2π. The π will cancel with the π. So I have 2n plus 1 divided by 4 because I have 2 already there and divide by 2 again. So that will be over 4 where n belong to integers. So n is equal to 0 plus or minus 1 plus or minus 2, etc. لاحظوا يا شباب الفترة المعطى minus 1 to 1. So what I need to do, I need to locate all points inside that interval. فراح أجي أعوض الآن في البداية n equal to zero. If n equal to zero, this will give me c is equal to 1 over 4. طبعا واضحه هذه between minus 1 and 1. So I accept it as a conclusion of the rules theorem. طيب n equal to 1, I am trying to look for the points in the positive direction now. If I substitute n equal to 1, what I will get here? C is equal to what? 3 over 4. Also, this one belongs to the interval minus 1 to 1. جيد. n equal to 2, this will give me what? C equal to 5 over 4, صحيح؟ This does not belong to the interval what? Minus 1 to 1. So I stop at the right, I go to the now to the left direction, or the to the negative direction of the interval, to the negative part of the interval, let me say it like this. So what will be the zeros inside that interval minus one, at the up to minus one? I will substitute n equal to minus one. طبعا, this will give me c is equal to minus one over four. Still, this is inside the interval minus one to one. N is equal to minus two. That will give me c equal to minus three over four, which is also inside the interval minus one to one. But if you go to n equal to minus 3, that will give you minus 6 plus, that is minus 5 over 4, which is not inside the interval minus 1 to 1. So how many points inside minus 1 to 1 satisfies Rolle's theorem? If in the exam they tell you the number of C's satisfying the Rolle's theorem for this function over this interval, the answer will be 4 points. We have 4 points satisfying the conclusion of Rolle's theorem. طيب, I have very nice question here, but before that one, I'd like to comment on the solution graphically. I would like to show you the graph of the sine function and illustrate why do we have such solution here, 4 points. I hope this will be enough space to graph it. Otherwise, I will explain it in the margin. Okay, let me see if this will be enough. كيف نرسم هذه الدالة يا شباب الأصلية الدالة الأصلية اللي هي sin 2 by x. I need the period. What is the period here? من يقول لي? What is the sin 2 by x? It is 2 by over 2 by. اللي هي كم تساوي? 1, isn't it? The answer will be 1. The period 2 by over b, if you remember from the prepare, 2 by over absolute value of b, if you like. If we assume this is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, then what I need to do, as we learned in math 002, I break this one into points, 4 points. The period is 1, so this is half of the period. This is 1/4 of the period. This is a 3/4 of the period. And we know the sine function. The sine function coming from 0 to 1, then it will come back to 0, then it will go to minus 1, then it will go back to 0, isn't it? Similarly, if we draw another period here, this will be minus 1/4, minus 1/2, minus 3/4, minus 1. So this is minus 1. And again, you start from 0, you go back to 1, then 0 again, then minus 1, then 0. Do you agree with this? This is minus 3/4 and so on. This is minus 1/4 exactly here. It's supposed to be something like this maybe. Yes. طيب, what does it mean? يعني our solution here, the algebraic solution, what does it mean geometrically? When you go to these points, 1/4, 3/4, what is happening there? Look at 1/4. When you draw a point here, try to draw the tangent line. What is the derivative here? F prime of 1/4 must be equal to 0. Similarly here, when you graph it here, the tangent line, you'll have F prime at 3/4 is equal to 0. Same thing here, we have F prime at minus 1/4 is equal to 0. And finally, I have it here, F prime at 3/4 is equal to 0. The derivative is equal to 0. That is the geometrical meaning of the solution we did by Rolle's theorem. I hope this is clear for you. If you have any question, please do not hesitate Just raise your hand and ask your question, please. Yes.
إذا ما تحققت أحد الشروط.
إذا ما تحقق أحسن سؤال جميل. إذا ما تحققت أحد الشروط. If one of these conditions is not there, or maybe more than one are not there. The conclusion will be we may have or may not have a point where the derivative is equal to zero. نعطيك مثال مثلا يعني مثلا ده لما كانت continuous مثلا we have something like this. This is a equal to one. This is a equal to one and this is b equal to four مثلا. Well, image of it is equal to one. I may have an uncontinuous function like this. And even though it has more than one c where the derivative is equal to zero, no problem. But in order to guarantee the existence of such a c, we must have the three conditions to be there. واضح النقطة؟ واضح الجواب حقك؟ والله لسه. If you lose the conditions, you may lose the conclusion, but not necessarily. ممكن تتحصل على نتيجة وممكن ما تتحصل على نتيجة. عشان تضمن وجود النظرية اللي هو النتيجة, you need to satisfy all the three conditions in the theorem. أي سؤال يا شباب؟ أي سؤال؟ هذا السؤال الآن الجاي يعتبر نوعا ما صعب لأنه هو في analysis. لكن nobody maybe will ask you about this in the final. لكن maybe in the quiz you may have or in the open questions or something like this. هو جاء مرة في فاينل يعني يكون سهل لو جاء في فاينل كمالتيبل تشويس. لو كان ريتن اكزام البعض ممكن يلخبط في مسائل زي كذا, لكن it is very simple. I will illustrate it ان شاء الله in very simple way in order for you to understand. هذا one of the applications for Rose theorem. احدى تطبيقات الروزي theorem is showing that the equation has exactly one root. اذا تتذكروا اخذنا نظرية شو يسموها intermediate value theorem. احد يتذكرها 2.5 intermediate value theorem كان تطبيق للcontinuity. شو كانت تقول النظرية هذه؟ If you have a function that is continuous over a closed interval and مثلا هذه f of a and this is f of b and you have a point here called n in between this is a and this is b in between f of a and f of b, so there must be a c here such that f of c equal to n. وطبقناه كحالة خاصة when we said if this is A, this is B and you have negative value here, a positive value here, in order to join them with a continuous curve, you must pass it through the x-axis. You must have a value of C here such that F of C is equal to zero. Is it only one time? We said no, at least one time. This is A, this is B. You may have something like this is negative. You go up, you go down, you go up, you go down and you go up. So how many C's we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So the intermediate value theorem does not say that you have exactly one C. It says you have at least one value of C for which the derivative is equal to what? Is equal to zero. I will try to solve this question with a certain technique. I will illustrate it for you. Then I will use it in the theorem. صعوبة السؤال مش لأنه صعب, لكن الفكرة حقا يمكن جديدة عليكم. الآن I will illustrate it and then I will illustrate the question. Okay شباب, in mathematics we have different ways to prove things. عندنا عدة طرق للإثبات. One of these which will be used in the question is called proof by contradiction. شنو يعني proof by contradiction؟ يقول بالعربي الإثبات بنفي النقيض. يعني عندك احتمالين, يا واحد أو اثنين. إذا أثبت أن الجواب مش اثنين أكيد الجواب راح يكون شنو؟ واحد. هاي يسموها الإثبات بنفي النقيض, proof by contradiction. أوضح لكم إياها بمثال, just funny question. يعني لو واحد قال لي اثبت أن الواحد أكبر من الصفر. الواحد هذا الواحد العدد واحد, اثبت أنه أكبر من الصفر. طيب عندنا مسلمات في الرياضيات اللي أخذناها في زير الزرع الأعداد الحقيقية. Out of these conditions, if you remember, مثلا ان الواحد هو اليونيتي, isn't it? يعني اضرب الواحد في اي عدد يعطيني العدد نفسه, صح لو لا؟ This is what I have. What else? اخذنا من مسلمات المتراجعات, اذا كان عندي a less than b وضربنا في عدد c وهو سالب, مثلا اذا كان c اصغر من الصفر, بيطلع عندي c a greater than c b, isn't it? When I multiply by negative sign. الآن كيف أثبت والله الواحد أكبر من الصفر باستخدام المعلومات هذه؟ أقول أوكي no problem. I will try to prove that one is greater than zero. طيب شلون نثبتها by contradiction؟ يقولوا أوكي خل نفرض نسلم مثلا أن الواحد لا الواحد أصغر من الصفر مش أكبر من الصفر مثلا. أوكي one is less than zero. Assume this. طيب خل نفرض هذا يقول لي assume that we have الواحد لا أصغر من الصفر مش أكبر من الصفر. يقول أوكي أنا أقول لي take any positive number أي يعني الأي شنو greater than zero. اختار لي أي عدد موجب يعجب في الحياة أي greater than zero. طيب ممتاز تأخذ لي هذا عدد أي وضربه في الواحد شو يصير الآن؟ الآن إحنا قلنا الأي greater than zero يلا راح نضربه في الواحد شو يصير؟ يصير one times a. طيب إذا هو أكبر من الصفر والعدد الواحد أصغر من الصفر شو يصير one times a greater than zero or less than zero؟
less
than zero لأن إحنا فرضنا الواحد أصغر من الصفر. طيب one times a هذا الواحد هو اليونيتي one times a يعطيني a صار عندي شنو الآن الفرض حقي الأسامشن إن الأي شنو greater than zero. إذا فرضنا هذا الاحتمال لازم بالضرورة ينتج عندي شنو الأي less than zero يصير عدد هو greater than zero and less than zero at the same time. يقولوا هنا في تناقض يقولوا هنا contradiction في تناقض contradiction. إذا في contradiction يعني شنو يعني الأسامشن هذا خطأ ما ممكن يكون and if it is not true معناته one greater than what one greater than zero. This is an idea about what we will use in the following exercise. يسموه إثبات في شنو بنفي النقيض. So this is what we call proof by contradiction. You assume something which is the negation of the required thing to be proved. And then you reach a contradiction. And then you say, okay, then my assumption will not be true. So the conclusion would be true. كأنك تناقش مع واحد وانتو بتعين والله هذا بننتي مش بننتي وبعد كده إذا أثبت لأنه بننتي خلاص متج وانتفى الثاني أو مثلا يقول له والله خلنا نسلم أنك على حق صحيح أنت مع واحد مثلا ذاك البعيد ملحد مثلا يقول له والله خلنا نسلم معاك أن الكون ولده صدفة وبعد كده توجد له أشياء يقول له شوف contradiction معناته ما ممكن يكون وجد صدفة معناته له خالق وهكذا هاي يسموه إثبات بالنفي النقيض proof by contradiction. ايش علاقته هذا مع الدرس حقنا ايش علاقته مع المثال يعني what is the relationship between proof by contradiction and this exercise here it seems it is very simple exercise yes it is very simple exercise let's go through it and try to find it out. اولا لاحظوا يا شباب هو يقول اثبت ان يوجد حل واحد فقط he did not say show that there is a solution. طيب لو قال لي سؤال show there is a solution ايش راح استخدم
greater than zero
intermediate value theorem راح استخدم النظرية السابقة صحيح. So this is the first step we will do. First step, step number one. Step number one. We use the intermediate value theorem راح اكتب بين قوسين 2.5 to show there is a solution. There is a root. يوجد على الأقل واحد في البداية خلنا نثبت إن there is at least one. So there is a root. شلون نستخدمها هذه؟ أول خطوة راح أقول okay let f of x equal to what? X cubed plus x minus one. Let this is f of x. جيد. يلا احسبوا لي الآن f of zero. This one which is what? Which is continuous everywhere actually. What is f of zero?
-1.
That is less than zero. طيب what about f of one? Which is greater than zero. I will choose this which I will say here which is continuous. لأن هذا هي requirements on the interval. 0 1 إذا تتذكروا 2.5 كان يقول لازم تكون الدالة متصلة بين الـ A والـ B. So it is continuous on this interval 0 and 1. طيب العدد 0 يقع بين وين؟ 0 is between f of 0 and f of 1. 0 is between f of 0 and f of 1. هذا ال n حقنا اللي في النظرية n equal to 0. So the conclusion, so by intermediate value theorem, شو موجود عندنا في intermediate, there is, أذكركم فيها أوريكم إياها, نرجع قديم جدا I 2.5. وين النظرية هذه intermediate value theorem؟ آخر الدرس كانت صحيح؟ هذا السؤال قديما هذا عملناه. وين النظرية؟ Okay, let me show you this. هذه النظرية موجودة أمامكم. Suppose there that is f is continuous on the closed interval a b and let n be any number between f of a and f of b, where f of a is not equal to f of b, then there exists a number c a b in between a and b open such that f of c equal to n. وطبقناها بالشكل هذا. شوفوا أنا نفس المثال x cubed minus x minus 1. تتذكروها هذه between 1 and 2 was the question. نحن عندنا between 0 and 1 we choose the interval. Okay, sometimes it is negative, sometimes it is positive. So there is a C such that f of C equal to 0. I am using exactly the same thing here. So there is what now? We say there is at least, there is a C, there is at least one number C between the open interval 0 and 1 in natija such that f of C is equal to 0. So the equation has at least one root. إذا كانت ال f of x equal to 0 for at least one c, so the equation has at least one solution. So I will say here, f and f c cubed, is it c cubed? C cubed plus c minus 1 equal to 0. لاحظوا يا شباب, إلى الآن إحنا ما أثبتنا يوجد حل وحيد فقط, only one unique solution. What we have proved it up to now, that there is a root, there is at least one root. الآن تجي قضية proof by contradiction. Step number two, step number two. لاحظوا يا شباب, step number two. الآن أنا عشان أثبت إن ماكو حل واحد فقط, شو راح أفرض يعني؟ طيب من يقول لي وش النقيض حق هذا؟ لما أقول there is at least one وأبغى أثبت there is only one. What is the negation of there is only one? إن احتمالات, هو نعرف إن في أصفار, في احتمالين عندنا الآن, إما يكون واحد من الأصفار أو شنو, ما حد يعرف,
يكون
أو أكثر من واحد, يا واحد أو أكثر من واحد, صح لو لا؟ صحيح, إحنا نعرف إن في أصفار بين between zero and one, but how many we don't know. إحنا راح نفرض الآن إحنا نبغى نثبت إن there is only one, not more than one, not more than one for sure. طيب شو نقول الآن؟ نقول assume عندنا أكثر من واحد. إذا أكثر من واحد على الأقل اثنين يعني. There are two roots. سميهم أنت مثلا C1 and, أو خلينا نسميها R1 and R2 مثلا. Two roots. R1 and R2. At least one, more than one, على الأقل اثنين. R1 and R2. يعني شنو R1 and R2 الآن؟ تعال. إذا عندي صفرين من الأصفار R1 and R2 اطلع لي على الدالة هذه. نوت هذه الآن f of x اللي اسمها x cubed plus x minus 1, وعندي فترة الآن اسمها الآن الفترة هذه R1 and R2. تمام, apply Rose theorem here, apply Rose theorem. هل الدالة هذه continuous, is it continuous between R1 and R2, yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, it is polynomial. Is it differentiable? Yes, it is differentiable. Yes. طيب الشرط الأول f is continuous. Okay, f is continuous on this interval R1, R2. Second one, f is differentiable on this interval R1, R2 since it is polynomial. Okay, R1 and R2. طيب الشرط الثالث شلون؟ Number three, what is f of r1? What is it equal to? مو قلنا هو root يعني zero, ويساوي أيضا شنو؟ f of r2. هل أستطيع أطبق الروز ثيورم الآن؟ Can I use روز ثيورم؟ By this implies now the three conditions implies by rules theorem. What do we have? النظرية الآن تقول بما أن الدالة continuous في الفترة هذه وأيضا differentiable في الفترة هذه, f of r1 equal to f of r2. By Rule's theorem, there is what? There is a number c. هذا سميه أنا سميته c كل c. خلنا نسميه أي عدد يعني هو c m whatever. Let me call it أنا راح أسميه c1. A number c1 such that what? F prime of c1 must be equal to what? Must be equal to zero. طيب ممتاز. What is f prime of c? خلونا نجي نجيد دالة f prime of c. شو يصير هذا من هنا 3c squared زائد شنو؟ زائد واحد equal to zero. بالله عليكم هل هذه لها حل المعادلة 3c squared plus 1 over real numbers؟
possible.
No. لا ما لها حل هذه contradiction هنا. يعني النتيجة حق النظرية ما تحققت صحيح؟ We don't have a zero for the derivative. We do not have a zero for the derivative. We do not have a zero the derivative. شلون يعني النظرية ما تتحقق؟ كل شروط النظرية موجودة. مع there is something in the assumption is not true. There is something in the assumption is not true. What is our assumption? There are two roots.
Two roots.
يعني معناته النتيجة شنو الآن؟ There is only one root for the equation. There is one root only for the equation. So that is the mainly the question. What I need from you, if you need to show me in the quiz a solution like this, ما أحتاج منكم الخطوة الثانية هذه اللي هي proof by contradiction. I don't like it because you haven't studied it. لكن هاي الطريقة اللي الكتاب قاعد يحل فيها. الآن شلون والله عادي شلون نعمل كل يعني راح تعملوا الخطوة الأولى هذه step number one. You show that there is a root. بعد كده ايش راح تعملوا يا شباب؟ راح تجي توجد الدريفيتيف. What is the derivative here? F of x. 3x square plus what? فراح تثبت لي إما الدريفيتيف دائما موجب أو دائما شنو سالب. طيب هل فعلا لما نثبت أن الدريفيتيف always positive or always negative then we will not have any other root؟ خلنا يوريكم هذه ليش هذا يكفي يعني. ونفرض الآن أنت هنا عندك دالة بالشكل هذا. هذه الA وهذه الB. And you pass through a point here. وأثبت أنت ان always the derivative is positive. ايش معنى always positive the derivative؟ يعني دالة شنو؟ always what؟
increasing.
فلما تمر بالنقطة هذه في امل بعد ترجع تمر بالزيرو مرة ثانية؟ impossible isn't it؟ impossible. It is always increasing. Always increasing and it will pass through a point. It will never come back to that point. لأن it's always increasing. نفس الشيء لو كان احنا قاعد always decreasing and we pass it through a zero we will never come back to that point. ما راح ترجع الدالة مرة ثانية because always decreasing. فاللي أبغى منك فقط شنو you prove that the derivative is always positive or the derivative is always what negative and that will be enough for me. If you can prove that the derivative is always positive or always negative after proving that there is a root it's enough to show that there is only one root. وضحت يا شباب؟ واضحة النقطة هذه؟
نعم واضحة.
Okay, good. الآن نجي إلى mean value theorem. I state it only. I prove it and I stop. I have 5 minutes to do so. النظرية هذه شو تقول the mean value theorem? Very interesting theorem. It says let f be a function that satisfies the following conditions. لاحظوا نفس الشروط موجودة. The function is continuous over the closed interval. The function is differentiable over the open interval. الشرط الثالث مش موجود. ما قال لي f of a equal to f of b. Not there. لو وضعها صارت شان صارت روز ثيورم. النتيجة شلون الآن؟ يقول there is a number c in a b such that f prime of c f prime of c it's equal to f of b minus f of a over b minus a. يقول بعض الأحيان يكتبها كده. يقول f of b minus f of a equal to f prime of c times b minus a. What does it mean geometrically? What does it mean geometrically? I will show you a graph by my hand and then I will show you a graph coming from the book. لاحظوا النظرية شو تقول؟ تقول هذه عندك الآن أنت هنا نقطتين. واحدة اسمها a and f of a and b and f of b. لاحظوا ال f of a not equal to f of b. And you are joining these two points, مثلا, you are joining them with, let us say, a curve like this. تمام? You are joining them with a curve like this. النظرية تقول there is a C such that f prime of C equal to f of b minus f of a over b minus a. هذه الكمية شنو معناتها؟ شنو معنى هذه؟ لاحظوا لي خط المستقيم السيكنت لاين هذا. Look for the secant line joining these two points. لاحظوا هذه النقطتين. هذه النقطة عبارة عن a sorry b and f of b as you can see. And this point is what a and f of a. This is the point a. This is the point b. شايفين الخط المستقيم الأزرق هذا. What is the slope of it? What is the slope?
F of b minus f of a.
The slope is exactly the right hand side here, isn't it?
Yes.
F of b minus f of a over b minus a. طيب النظرية شنو معناتها الآن؟ There is a value of c such that f prime of c equal to this number. طيب هذا ميل مستقيم. هو قاعد يقول لي إن الدريفيتيف يساوي الميل هذا. شنو معناتها؟ It means there is a tangent line whose slope is equal to what? Equal to the slope of the secant line here. بمعنى آخر, there is a C here. When I go to the graph and draw the tangent line will be parallel to the secant line. واضحة؟ The tangent line is parallel to the secant line. Only one time? The theorem says at least one time. You may have another one here, for example. There is a C here, C1, let me call this one C2, such that the tangent line, when I graph it here, it will be what? These lines are parallel. These lines are parallel. واضحة النقطة؟ طيب شلون نثبتها هذه؟ شلون نثبتها؟ Quickly. It is not needed from you, but I will prove it for you quickly. طيب راح نعرف دالة. أوجد لي معادلة المستقيم هذا. مستقيم السيكنت هذا. واضح المستقيم هذا؟ شنو معادلته؟ خلينا نسميها LX هنا. تصير معادلته. I will use this point. So f of it will be y minus y1, يعني y minus f of a equal to the slope اللي هو f of b minus f of a over b minus a. طبعا هذا هو السلوب times what x minus a. صحيح؟ This is what we have. I have the function, the black one here is f of x. شوفوا يا شباب راح اعرف دالة اسميها h of x. هذه عبارة عن شنو؟ عبارة عن f of x الدالة الأصلية اللي هي بالأسود مرسومة ناقص المعادلة هذه. الآن if you solve for y you have f of a plus. لما تاخذ الطرح يصير عندك هنا بين قوسين, يصير عندك هنا f of a minus f of a plus f of b minus f of a over b minus a times x minus a. شغلة زي كده. طيب I will put the minus sign inside, so I'll erase these brackets. So I have here minus, I have here what? Minus. هذه الدالة الجديدة هذه, لاحظوها لاحظوها. خلينا نشوف هل الدالة هاي تحقق رولز ثيورم أو لا. If you give me one minute please. Does it satisfy rules theorem? هل الدالة هذه continuous? It is continuous over the closed interval. ليش؟ لأن الدالة f of x معطاة في السؤال إن هي continuous. وهذا خط مستقيم continuous. Difference between two continuous functions continuous. Is it differentiable? Yes. هذه معطاة في السؤال إن f of x differentiable في النظرية موجود, والخط المستقيم أيضا differentiable because it has a slope which is f of b minus f of a over b minus a. So the difference between two differentiable is also what? Differentiable. يبقى لنا الشرط الأخير. What is h of a? يلا نحسبها. What is h of a? أحصل عندي هنا f of a minus f of a minus f of b minus f of a over b minus a times a minus a. كم الجواب هذا؟ طبعا هذه زيرو وهذا زيرو, صار الجواب شنو؟ صار زيرو. طيب h of b شو يساوي h of b؟ يطلع عندي f of b minus f of a minus f of b minus f of a over b minus a times b minus a. عوضنا مكان الـ x بـ b. So this will be cancelled out. And what do we have here? We have f of b minus f of a minus f of b plus f of a. يعني الناتج شنو؟ زيرو. يعني تحققت النظرية rules theorem. النتيجة شلون؟ There is a point c whose derivative is equal to what? Is equal to zero. يلا خلونا ناخذ الـ derivative حق الـ h prime, حق الـ h of x. هذه راح تصير h prime and it will be zero. راح نعوض هنا, يصير f prime and this will be what? C. And what is the derivative of the remaining? This is zero. What is the derivative of this quantity here? This will be one, so that will be what? Yeah, the conclusion will be zero is equal to F prime of C minus this quantity. F of B minus F of A over B minus A. We take this one to the other side and we have the conclusion of the mean value theorem. هاي طريقة الإثبات. I will, inshallah, solve questions about this theorem at the beginning of the next class. This is the geometrical meaning. قلنا على الأقل راح يكون في خط موازي إلى الخط اللي يربط بين النقطتين A and B. مثلا هنا خط واحد، هنا خطين. But at least one time you will have a tangent whose slope is equal to the slope of the secant line. جملة أخيرة فقط. I will stop here. لو صار ال f of b يساوي f of a، هذه النتيجة شو تصير؟
صفر.
صفر. وش سموها النظرية الآن يصير؟ هذه مين فاتهم شو تصغر شو تصير؟ إذا أضفنا الشرط الثالث f of b equal to f of a، صارت النتيجة f prime of c is equal to zero. سموها شنو؟
رولز
ثيورم. رجعت يعني الرولز ثيورم هي حالة خاصة من وين؟ من mean value theorem. Rossi theorem is a special case of the mean value theorem. If we add a third condition, that is f of a equal to f of b, then we have Rossi theorem. Sorry to take this much from your time, but I think it is good to seek proofs from time to time to give you a depth in your understanding. I will inshallah solve just exercises about this theorem next time, and inshallah will introduce the next point. So that's it for today. Assalamu alaikum. If you have any question, I will stay here for a couple of minutes if you have questions. Otherwise, that's it for today.